In part one of our report on GRDC's stubble height and crop emergence trial at Downside in southern New South Wales, we saw the dramatic difference in crop emergence. On the left of screen, an average 30 plants per square metre, and on the right, just half that number. The difference was the canola on the left was planted where wheat had been harvested at a height of 60 centimetres and the standing stubble burnt prior to canola being sown. While on the right, the header cut much lower at 15 centimetres and the stubble was spread and retained.
And it's this chaff even more than the actual standing stubble that I think is really hindering that emergence of the canola.
As well as these treatments, there were two others trialled. A high cut without a follow-up burn, which resulted in 24 plants per square metre, and a third high cut followed by a K-line trash cutter. It resulted in 16 plants per square metre, similar to the low cut and retained stubble treatment. The entire canola crop had been sown using a single disc seeder.
The smaller the seed, the more vulnerable it is to desiccation by hairpinning and or poor contact with the soil.
In those treatments where stubble load was higher, the disc seeder wasn't always able to get the desired seed-soil contact. The heavy load of chaff, straw and trash resulted in the disc wedging straw into the narrow furrow, creating a barrier between the canola seed and the soil, what's known as hairpinning.
There's always a lot of consideration and discussion around the best sowing system to use, disc versus tines, level of disturbance, row spacing, things like that. A trial like this is valuable in terms of quantifying how one of those elements, being the choice to use a disc here, interacts with different stubble treatments.
As growers start to turn their attention to harvest, this trial is producing timely data for decision making. What's the best cutter bar height to optimise cereal harvest efficiency and yield? And what's the most appropriate stubble management strategy for maintaining the benefits of a retained stubble farming system while keeping in mind how seeding machinery will cope with potentially high stubble loads? Real issues requiring local solutions.
A lot of these trials are actually being conducted by farming systems groups in the regions addressing their problems. And the great thing about that is that if growers can actually see the results of these trials in their region, then there's a really good chance that they're going to adopt any practice change that's recommended by that research.
Early adopters of this trial's outcomes could potentially improve farm returns as soon as this harvest. As the trial continues, additional research data will be added, including canopy temperature measurements and frost events, which are being recorded in collaboration with New South Wales DPI for GRDC's Frost Initiative. After this canola is taken off, there'll be a different stubble scenario to add to the research data and to the outcomes of the broader 5-year National Stubble Initiative, which the GRDC has invested in.
The great thing about the variety of trials that we're doing in the Stubble Initiative is that we can actually learn from the lessons of people in other regions. So those results can be adopted either in the southern region or it might be the northern or western region. So there's plenty that we can learn from each other.
The southern edition of September's Ground Cover has a report on this project. And for more information about the research and its outcomes, go to FarmLink Research. And under projects, look for retained stubble.